roughly equivalent to what in high school, and the fetal pig would be called the adventitia. I will probably ask you, another name for the tunica serosa is what? And we give you three or four choices, and you want to get adventitia. But if I'm talking, I should be probably use tunica serosa. This is a covering membrane, covers and interconnects. Making a sense out of this, it's a membrane. Or a phrase, membrane that covers and interconnects. In the colon, or large intestine, the other day we saw that it was pouched. Pouches were called hostra, or each one a hostra. Why do they do that? Why do they pouch up? They pouch up because their tunica muscularis is not complete like the tunica muscularis that we just drew. The tunica muscularis over there has a circular inner layer that goes all the way around the entire GI tract. And then that is surrounded by the longitudinal layer. But in this, the muscle, I guess I should try to stick with the red as long as it lasts, the muscle is in three bands. Bands are wider, they're drawn, so increase the size. These are called the tineae coli. Tineae coli have three bands of longitudinal circular smooth muscle still goes all the way around, but the longitudinal is broken into three bands. If I were to try to draw that for you, here's the colon. Have a band of circular smooth muscle, longitudinal smooth muscle. One band of it is back here, and going down the back side. Our second band is over here, coming down this side. Is this is green. These are the three bands. These three bands do not contract at the same time. If they did, this cut plane or surface would decrease or move equally on all sides. I'm sure you've had the experience, not one to keep you awake at night, of trying to raise or lower Venetian blinds or level oars. I'm not talking about taking level oars or anything like that, changing their angle. I'm saying, oh, time to wash the window. So let's raise the whole thing, okay? So you grab the cord at one side and you try to do that. And what happens? One side goes up, the other side lags behind and it's going up at an angle. You stop. You get over there and you pull the high end down equal to the other end and you get back to the cord and very carefully this time, see if you can get both sides to come up at the same time. Otherwise, they were going to bunch. Now, in the colon, there are three cords. Picture a triangle, okay? A wooden triangle, big. This is one side. Here's one corner of the triangle. Here's one corner of the triangle. Okay, the other corner of the triangle is there. Put a cord, Tenier coli, to each one of them. Put all three up there, throw them over a pipe or something, and pull on them. Unless they're all the same length and being pulled exactly at the same time, that triangle, that wooden triangle, is not going to raise smoothly and straight up. It's going to go like this, and like this, and like this. You can do it, but in the human body, it's not done. In the human body, they are contracted, the tenier coli are contracted at different times, causing the hostra to form, causing the bunching, and causing the contents to be packaged, essentially, and pushed along. If I end up having to send you notes to read, well, that's probably going to be easier than, I know you have a reading assignment too, but did you ever have a class in high school, history especially, read this chapter, you're going to have a test tomorrow. And it's so boring anyway.